So welcome back from the break. It's the entertainment review right on Metro Television. My name is Desifadin, the Starboy, here with Isidro Akumia, Helen K. And of course, our guest, one of them is here with us, Yao Beck. He's here with us. And we'll get to talk about some stuff later with him. But we are talking music video production and how it helps, you know, boost, you know, one's song or the sale of it. And so today, a fresh one dropped. And we just want to have a quick review on that. And then we get to engage our guest here, Yao Beck. So can you drop the video for his new song that is Champagne? Hey. I love the tune, but the music video, I don't know. So we just want to understand the concept of music videos and how artists, whether artists decide that, yo, I want you to do it this way to the music video directors or the directors, say, bring up the plan or do together, whatever that it is. So if we can have Champagne by Kitty, and then we just have a quick review of that and we get to Yao Beck.
It is an absolute pleasure that I am here with all of you to honor a man that has led by example. He's a family man. He is an accomplished academic. He is a leader. But before I ask this handsome gentleman to come on stage, we've actually prepared a nice clip of some of his memorable moments. So ladies and gentlemen, please. Let's have a look.
Ooh, baby, you know we outside. Yeah, yeah, we outside. You know we outside.
Champagne for my pain, I stay in my lane. Every day is my birthday, wait till we get. Champagne for my pain, I stay in my lane. Every day be my birthday, it be we day. Body like a panda, the way she moving make a panda. Break it down, make it wiggle like a banana. I want to know what you make me in the corner. Bouncy, 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 baby, bouncy, bouncy, ma. Bouncy, 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 baby, bouncy, bouncy, ma. Champagne for my pain, I stay in my lane. Every day is my birthday.
So that's the song by Kitty, and the video was dropped today. Champagne. Now, let me just get to Isidro. You have been telling me that you don't understand
it. I don't get it. It's one thing that is one issue that I've had with quite a number of artists.
Okay.
Because like I was telling you earlier, the music video is supposed to, you know, like put some more emphasis or some in-depth understanding into the music that was earlier released.
Mm-hmm.
So if I'm not getting that in the music video, and at the end of the day, one thing that we should also see is that not just is it, you know, putting some in depth into the original, the music itself,
yeah, the song
but then
itself,
it's supposed to entertain us as well.
Mm-hmm.
So if, I'm watching the music video, I know the lyrics, I'm watching it, I'm not really understanding, do you think I'll be entertained? Because I'm watching it and I feel lost.
So you feel lost with
and
this,
I'm trying to
the
figure,
whole drama in the
because
beginning.
Because look at the beginning of the, I just, and it's being accused of tax fraud.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then, then all of a sudden then we see that, Kitty comes in and then he's,
With his crew.
With his crew and then all that. And then what are you trying to say?
Okay.
Understand me? And then there are quite a number of artists out there. I'll mention it. Quickly, the Traveler. I know that a lot of people say that when the music video came out, people were loving it. But there were a lot of people too that did not love it because they didn't get the concept. Like how was that in line with the song itself?
Helen.
I
thought about this.
Yes, when I was watching the music video, in fact, I saw Mac Brown in there.
Yeah.
I saw
Ajitana.
And then I was thinking, what is the purpose? I know sometimes, celebrities that we know, we already know them, we like them. So maybe it's to just promote the music. So when we see them in there, we know them, so mm-hmm. yes, it would probably like the music and everything. But then again, what is the storyline?
Mm-hmm.
What the music is about? Is that what the music video is actually portraying?
Yeah.
What is it? Uh-huh. Yeah. So sometimes I don't really know what make them or how they decide to make a music video, what the management thinks, what the artist thinks, what sauce is. But I think immediately we see a music video, we should be able to get an understanding of it. Mm-hmm. They don't really need to even now come and explain to us.
We should. So I think. Fortunately, we have an artist in the building,
exactly.
so he'll be helping us understand how they do all that. He's looking all fresh, you know, the glasses and the earrings, the haircuts.
Yeah, for me.
Yalbek, good afternoon and welcome to the show.
Good afternoon, bro, Charlie. Thanks, man.
How you doing?
Thanks, man. I've been out here, Charlie.
Great. So, let's just get off with music video productions. I mean, let me start with you. Mm-hmm. If you put out a song, how do you decide that I want to make a video for this particular song?
Okay, so first of all, it starts from you, the artist.
Okay.
Because you are the creative. You know what you are saying in a song. You know how you want to paint the story or paint the picture.
Okay.
So first of all, you, the artist, need to have like a raw picture of what you want to get from the song as for visuals.
Okay.
Yeah, so you having that, if you have somebody personal, if you don't, you get a director to also bring his idea on board. And then you and your team can decide to pick his or give him your idea or he will blend or whatever it is. So it depends on you and your team, first of all.
Do you make like a song like Independence Lady?
Yeah.
I saw that, you know, there was a video of a lady, you down the walk on a road, you know that kind of thing. So at what time do you decide that want to make it like a story to tell what it... Because we know some songs will be just... what's this 3D background thing?
Yeah.
Bah, 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 we are gone. Some others to have the story to it. At what point do you decide that I want there to be a story in this particular video?
Okay, so like you said, I'll take it from the part you just said. Some people stand behind white backgrounds and stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so we have musicians and we have artists.
Okay.
And a musician is deeper because musician knows like the words you put in the song, like you know the story. You're already imagining it like a movie. Before you go record the song already, because to the next person, he or she should get like where you're coming from. Starting then, how can to where? When did this happen? When did that happen? So you, the musician, you know the story in the music, and that is how you have to correspond it to the video.
Okay.
Yeah. So you and Kasa be the machine, first of all.
Okay.
Yeah. You know, be the director. He does the handle camera. So you can tell him, oh, okay, no, this side, I said that. I feel like if we add this, then he'll be like, no, that one, unless we use this light, or unless we use that. So first of all, it's you. But the artists, like I said, they will just want to do just any German song, and it wouldn't need any kind of storyline or any. I don't do such music, you get it?
Okay.
Music I do will always contain a story. So if I'm putting it into visuals, it should be from a point to a point, from preface to chorus, from verse to this, it should continue.
Do you believe that every music video, the storyline that is put in there should correlate necessarily with the song, the lyrics of the song?
I feel like that's how it's supposed to be because I don't think I'll be watching a movie and they say Nyame Boame and then I'll be seeing people throwing money and things. No, I'm not sure.
But is that the case in Ghana? Do we see music videos really corresponding to the song?
I feel like the industry is shifting to the extent whereby people don't care about that anymore. That's how I feel.
Yeah, okay.
People don't care about...
People don't care again.
Okay, so as she said, I'm thinking that literally or bringing the literature of what we were doing. So maybe one of my favorite videos would be LJZ, Odor Bye Bye. That song communicates a lot. And it doesn't tell directly that, okay... He's just saying bye bye. Even where the water, it tells that the woman has given birth to something new. So, would you want your music video to just be okay, bye bye, you know, bye bye, just normal bye bye? You want there to be a deeper understanding. But that one, too, like she's saying, now people for rag them and brains and understand what you
the
want
people,
to communicate.
Yeah. That is creativity and that is like timeless.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, if I'm not getting it,
I'm coming to your point.
Okay.
Your point is you will get it.
Yeah.
You know why you will get it.
Why?
If you fall in love with the story, what are they saying? You watch it over and over to get
then
it.
Then I'll get the understanding and get as I watch it over and over.
That's the beauty of music. If I do it bang for you like that too, no.
No,
so
like
that's how come some music, there are some parts you don't even hear what he was saying. Mm-hmm. I just love the vibe. Because it can be, and you follow. Because it sounds nice on the beat.
It sounds nice like that.
Necessarily doesn't mean you should understand everything. It happens.
Is it expensive to shoot a video?
Yeah, it is. It is, very.
What's the highest you've paid?
Oh, me, I've paid 20K before. Independent Lady Remix. Yeah, I shot it 20? With Boats. Yeah, me so and Kelvin Boy and Miss V. Everybody was styled. The set was catered for and everything. All of that coming to, combination for the budget.
So before doing a music video, do you actually consider the cost that, I want to spend like 20,000 on it or maybe 100,000? Do you consider the amount before you even start? And do you say that, I don't want to exceed this particular amount?
Yes, first of all, everything be finance. Everything be your momo account inside.
Okay.
First of all, you go check.
Okay.
Yeah.
You see the heaviness. Sometimes, even because of budget and finance, it makes you keep your best songs.
Okay.
But sometimes you don't want to spoil or release the song just anyhow. Okay. You want to relax. Maybe you're dreaming of Mo Musa, you're dreaming of T.G. Omori.
Omori, yeah.
So you can't just use your coins to go and shoot some normal video. So first of all, it's the budget.
Okay.
If it goes look good for you, fine. If it doesn't, say, the highest people, the low people, 2 days. So you just choose which is which. Okay.
What do you feel about artists using their music video platforms to influence their fans politically?
I don't support that because I be general, I be for everybody. I'm supposed to be able to live in an Arabian country, Spanish, so I try to learn every language.
Okay.
I can't be for MPP or for NDC.
Yeah.
I don't know.
But you vote?
I've never done from 2018. I never did. I'm saying it.
So you don't go vote 2018?
No, I don't think so. It's like it's an opinion. You're going to share your opinion.
Yeah.
Well, I like this person. I like this person. I don't like anybody. I do.
Why though? Because at least you have to have a choice. I like this person, but then I wouldn't want to vote.
They can force you to have a choice. And it's still your choice to take their choice.
Interesting.
Very interesting.
We'll be playing Efan Hobeng. That's his new one. He dropped that video a couple of months back.
Yeah.
We'll play that. He's got Tulenke on that particular one. But I just want to ask how you've grown, because I'm seriously loving the kind of answers you're giving to the questions that we... it's making it really productive.
Yeah.
How have you grown from when you started as the Albeck that everybody was seeing like, okay, that's the Albeck, and till now? What has been that growth for you?
Okay, so me, in my life right now, not even musically, I've grown like personally, on my personal life. Because, music is part of it because entertainment gives people the chance to enter your life.
Yeah.
And people like me, we had the privilege of seeing the spotlight earlier, like the spotlight very early.
Okay.
So we were a bit naive. But coming to this point, sometimes you for read, you for know something. So I'll say the growth, I'm just learning. Not going back to my mistakes, just hit the nail with it, just like that. Let's go. I'm just facing front.
Okay.
So I'll just say, I thank you for you saying, like, I'm growing. I'm not even seeing. I'm just trying to do better. Yeah.
I was just saying that because of a number of things that have happened, which I don't want us to go there, but a lot of people would have heard the name and will be thinking, okay, the other guys have nothing.
Yeah.
But sometimes when you get into contact with them, then you understand the sort of things that they're putting out.
Yeah.
So I think we can just have his video now. And when we come back, we'll talk about his latest project, whatever thing that he's pushing. I saw him perform at the University of Ghana and some other places too. We'll talk about that. So we can have the Albeck song, Efa.
Mogo! Tule! I'm a man. 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 I'm a man.
Mabompaya, Shemanantia, Mamataya, Jaima bread, Naminya do, Timunja, Minamin blow, Makoji Mutu, Kosma bread, Cotton Quani, Yumadia, Fisemajija, Mibidiasa, Adichia, Makoda, Dem, Sikanashio, Miniti, Sikanashio, Namabunsu, Miniatio, Demeka, Fama Mu, and yes, I beham you, Parenti Asu, Obebuami, Abuami, Mami Futu, Namabre,
SBO, ID Mu. Ninina Esika, office money or fraud money. Ninina Esika, SBO, ID Mio. Ninina Esika, office money or fraud money. Mina menya miska, namesi ebi, midi bi achilia, non so far away. Mina menya miska, namesi ebi, midi bi achilia, non so far away. Afe me dia zikana shu, zikana shu, zikana shu.
Okay, so welcome back. Usikano, I saw Kipri as a machine. Or you'll be singing the song. You'll be singing the same song as Yalbeka that featured Tulenke and Guru on the It's a Fawo Hombe. So that brings us to 52 minutes after three right here on Metro Television. It's Entertainment Review. And we'll get back to you, Beck. So, what are you doing now? Like your own stuff, or you're signed on to?
I mean, before that, you know, the video.
Okay.
Yes, so I'm interested in that because you know, I was telling you guys earlier that some weeks ago, I interviewed the creative director from the Gbevu Nation.
Okay.
And he was speaking about the Wolves video, and he mentioned that you know, getting people to come and be part of the video was not that difficult because they just threw it out there and the guys just came in their cars and everything. And looking at how amazing this video is, I want to know how difficult was it for you to get, was it easy, was it difficult for you to get people to come on board and make a very successful video?
Nothing is easy, first of all.
Okay.
So it will never be easy. Mr. Easy self, no say no. So, the whole thing is about planning. So,
right.
Yeah, songs like this, or songs actually now, like, go on the platforms like iTunes and stuff earlier than it even comes out on our phones.
Okay.
Yeah.
It can even take, like, 3-4 months to plan just one project.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you have to get everything in place. Okay, your boys know, oh, 24th, we're shooting. They all need to know.
Mm-hmm.
Constant reminder. Oh, Charlie, 24th. Yeah, and definitely... So that's how it is. We get the songs done. Yeah. Right now, because of mobile studio, recording is not like, it doesn't take time.
Yeah.
You just do it, send it. But for video and stuff, you need to plan.
Right.
The director needs to find, even if it rains and it doesn't need rainfall in the video, no, it's a no-no. Next time.
That's a rainfall. Adults
will be if it doesn't get sunshine, cry, they want.
Yeah.
You go feed boycott them. If the clouds are in like that, he may not do it. So it's all timing.
Right.
A friend of mine was telling me that Charlie, these days we don't have to bash artists anymore because the industry itself is not helping them. Do you think we should be bashing people?
He really wants to speak his heart.
I feel like this is the time you people should like even support and push.
Right.
Oh, that one they always do.
Because me, I'm not even talking for myself right now.
Okay.
Yeah, because me, I've been on the sidelines for a while.
Mm. Yeah.
But for my brothers who are making and putting like Ghana up there, this is the time. Nigerians are doing more. We can also do same. But that little, like, they talk with the day in top, with the doing this, it limit artists. somebody that can, I mean, probably bring you Grammy and you'll be doing him like that. He thinks he's Ghana rapper.
No, but do you think really that is what is happening?
That is our problem. It's not like that is what is happening. It is a problem. It's a tag.
A problem of which people? Like which
is it a critic a or no, I just what is that?
Hear. We have people like that.
No, I just want to hear
have some people in some box.
Okay.
They have so that in their head. We are critics. We are critics.
But don't you think that they put you on your feet as well? But don't you think they put you on your
feet? I've been on several interviews. Like, I'm being honest. Mm-hmm. At first, I was a bit tense because I cut off interviews for a long time. It gives me problems.
Okay.
They, sometimes, some of them sometimes just put you on the to Sports? Try and get something.
To
like,
get something.
I mean, like, where are we going with this? I brought a song. Yo, Charlie, you know how they bought me more. We know how they move.
They know how we roll.
It takes some stories just to try and get you to say something and then boom.
Maybe sometimes they just want to get an understanding because maybe something has happened and then, you know, they've not gotten
and,
to speak with.
And immediately that something like that happens,
yeah.
You can't come back. So they don't need an understanding.
You know, this part of the interview came very late. We have to get you back here to talk.
So they just try to, some of them just try to use you to trend there.
Then go stress you.
They'll stress you.
Try to get you to say something.
So some.
Yes,
oh, some of who? No, the critics. The people who
like, do you, like you said, you don't want to.
At first, I was naive, like I said.
Okay.
I took it very emotional those days. Right now, I know they care. Like, man, found.
Okay. Yabek, we've got to wrap it up. What's the latest with you?
So I've been off the scene for a while. I'm sorry, guys. I traveled a bit, but I'm back now. I'm going to give you guys new music soon. Friday, I have a new one coming. It's called Date.
Date.
So make
taking someone on
date.
A date?
Yeah, put that date in your head.
Oh.
Make it a date. So 23rd September, we dropping date. Make them just watch out.
Okay. Thank you so much, Yabek, for coming. Really grateful. So this is where we wrap up the show. Unfortunately, Kweku Flake was supposed to come through, but he couldn't be here. Well, we'll do that some other time. Thank you so much for joining us on the show today. My name is Desi Fading, the Starboy, and I was here with... Sedu Akumia and also Helen K. We'll be back tomorrow. Tomorrow's a holiday, 21st, Kwame Nkrumah Memorial Day. So just enjoy your holidays. And big shout out to the production team. Nane Atana Bwache to the guys that I don't want to mention anybody. Jesse Steven, Steven Stevenson, to Tornado, to Ken, who is bringing us News Flash.
Kiki, yes, Kiki.
And to everybody.
Yeah,
thank you guys so much.
You.
We're back tomorrow, same time, 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. Entertainment Review. Have a great day. Bye-bye.